Hello there, Sagittarius. We have the third eye chakra that popped out twice. Okay. The dynamic. This is a pretty card. And transition. Purple, intuition. This card popped out twice. And then we're going to dig into the past to see who else is coming up in your past. Might be coming up in your future energy or your current energy, right? The frequency of the eye chakra. Your third eye chakra. Blah! Some kind of truth, right? The frequency of the third eye chakra, the indigo flower. Supports our intuition and our inner knowing and our imagination and our psychic abilities. The dynamic supports our ability to harmonize between layers and aspects of different origins and frequency. It helps us to put together the reality that's made up of different elements, both familiar and completely new, with ease, grace, and great joy. The frequency of transition supports our deep understanding of every changing nature of existence in our lives, so that we can learn to let go, surrender to the process, allow transition to occur with ease and grace. Grace twice. Truth. Some kind of truth came out with that third eye chakra. That's confirmation. Something needed to be set right, be fair. It was a yes. It was structure, intelligence, mind, body, and soul. So using your masculine energy, you was balanced. Oh, that's what this person was doing. They was unemotional, analyzing. They was making balanced judgment and was excited. So this is how this person was. This air energy, whatever communication with this intuition, right? With this third eye chakra. Yeah, but it caused the tower moment. I guess not only... They was making head over heart decisions. They could have been a manager. Authority. Now, authority came out twice. Also would activate, and I put it back. Because I want to pull a card I never seen before. But I just said forget it after intuition kept popping out third eye twice. So, judgment, self-elevation, awakening. So, this is what's going on. Somebody is seeing the truth. Somebody started seeing things fairly in the past. That's what caused this tower moment, which we had in the last reading. It was from their childhood memories. In their youth. It made whatever truth they seen, it made them, they pass influence from their childish ways and creativities. I guess this person started whatever they was trying to build in or have some kind of authority, balance, and excited about, they was loving it with that heart chakra. They was loving where they were at. But it was a challenge when it came to tradition. The relationships, the roles were reversed. The men was using the women and the women were putting in the work. The roles were reversed with these people that this person grew up around or the women they were dating. That's why it was so much sadness and pain in the relationship and tired moments in the relationships. So this could be a Libra. The opposite is Aries or Scorpio Taurus. We got Taurus out here. It could be a water sign. Other water signs, Pisces, Scorpio, and Cancer. But it was innocence. They wanted to juggle. So this is the truth coming out. They was ups, going through ups and downs, and there whenever they would return. So somebody wanted to take control of these untraditional ways in their family or challenges in relationships and lifestyle they were living. They want to self-elevate. They made a snappy judgment. So to me, they were so busy trying to build a structure, they made a snappy judgment that cost the time moment, returning back to their roots with nothing they was committed to. Roles were reversed. They was too busy committed to trying to be the one that get the most out of it, trying to be the one that always want to win, trying to be the one that get the upper hand, trying to have control. That's why this shit was going on. Trying to lead and had no leadership. That's why this was going on. Couldn't keep their private part to their fucking selves. Yeah, they wanted to take some kind of control. And then whatever kind of money, what they went over there, whatever control they tried to get, they karma was, they started having misery, greed, bad debt, money problems, strangling, stranded, unpaid bills. And what else is the truth? This is the truth. Yeah. Whatever judgment or balance they thought they was going to get and put in the hard work and have self-discipline for, they thought they was going to have victory. They got wound up, whatever judgment they made or snappy judgment they made or decision, it was a negative pattern. This is why we've been talking about the last three videos. This person, so this is all the same shit. They get impulsive and had wasted talent and opportunity all over again. It was a waste of talent and opportunity. They put in work is two things that was a waste of time. So let's keep going. So how does this person, it's one thing to say, this person left me because it was something about me they did not like. And that did not like could have been that you had your shit together. So what do you do when you want better or you're doing better? This person didn't leave you because you didn't have it together and they thought they could control you. They would have stayed with you then. And then some of them, you like, okay, well, that's what they didn't like about me. So if they come back the same, you still not gonna like things about them that's negative, but now you getting better and you always was better. What the fuck you do about that? Because that's what that sound like. They want to go build a bear. They want to go Mr. and Mrs. Potato Head somebody, put them together. So let's see what's the current energy or what they should be asking themselves or what you need to be asking yourself. So what's the current energy? What's the theme of the month? What's the key goal we need to be pursuing and the obstacles to overcome? A major accomplishment? What to avoid? What to embrace? And what to find support and advice and encouragement? Yeah, the current energy is you've been studying, you've been collaborating, you've been enjoying getting the money, you've been aligned. You made a decision with these two men to get some kind of support or with this job to whatever's going good for you with this Capricorn energy. You getting it, putting in the work, multitasking. Yeah, you putting shit to end when it comes to this communication. What situation in your life needs to come to an end? What is it? That you taking losses. if this person think that you're going to collaborate or, you know, get with them, you're going to put that to an end. They going to be confused with that Gemini energy too. And I feel like they won't be confused. It's not in reverse. Yeah, you're healed. What's that, 14? What is 14? Delivery and salvation. That's where you are. Sitting up in my room, I must confess, I was a mess 'cause of you. You in reality. Sitting up in my room, so once again, friend, whoever this person will collaborate and work hard for, that shit, they just needed to disconnect from a lot of people or something that was big that came up, right? Sorry. Because they was trying to avoid tragedy, and they still are. Scorpio, Taurus energy. Gemini, Sagittarius energy. Capricorn. Cancer is probably somebody they joint with. But you over there making shit fat with yourself with this Libra energy, balancing things. While this Scorpio is in reality that they need to disconnect, and that's why they trying to avoid some kind of tragedy. Yeah, you putting your time and energy somewhere else, and with that seven, you getting lucky. Yeah. Yeah. A Page of Pentacles, the skills are, what skills are called to be developed. So while you sitting up in my room, you could be thinking about new things you could be doing or getting back to in this earth energy. Yeah, things you've been studying or wanting to do, or you might have more time to do it, or more money, or more people to help you, wherever it is that you've been wanting or needing, filling in your blank, your void. Yes, I told you, stop playing with me. You put shit to an end. Okay. So this person putting shit to an end when it comes to that Gemini energy, it could be communication. They putting shit in there in reality about the people and places they've been going, but they still in reverse, Scorpio. Maybe because they're thinking about putting their time and energy somewhere else, trying to avoid tragedies. And you over here looking like a star, and that's probably what they looking at, and they in reality about you being a motherfucking star. Or they probably thinking about how they are pouring things out and thinking about what's gonna make them a star. Which that 17 on this star card. Your soul divine purpose needs to be taken in the forsake of your mind. That's how they feeling. Yeah, with this 7 in the reverse, they not feeling lucky. They feel like they need to put up protections and boundaries. I mean, that's not what they're doing. And that's probably why it's going to be a tar moment anyway. It's probably what they don't get. It's not about them going another place, getting another job, getting another relationship, going to another city, traveling, whatever they plan on doing, going to another website, whatever it is that they think they're doing. If they don't change their attitude or change the way they decided to not learn from their mistakes, they're not going to get lucky with this 7. What needs to be healed in order for you to recognize your deepest dreams? That's where they are, what they thinking. Remember that we said they're going to keep going through time moments? And so, while you over there chilling, in reality, about where you putting your time energy, they trying to collaborate, and shit gonna still come to an end, and they gonna see that quick with the communication with that Gemini, that it's now they stuck in something they can't get out of with someone, and that someone could be just a page that's trying to fulfill some dream. But they ain't got no backbone, or they don't have no boundaries, or they have no loyalty and passion. This is Sagittarius energy. No, that's Leo's energy, the Seven of Wands. They have no boundary. They don't know how to put people in their place. But they over there thinking about what, ghosting this person instead of trying to prevent a tragedy. But you don't have the backbone to put your guard up in protection like you did. That's why your shit is still moving. And now they're learning how important it is to have boundaries. So you can get somebody to respect you and have your own fucking self-respect and keep it. And not have to prove shit. And not let shit get too far. Like this shit is doing. Now they are lying on their back over there with a page. They think they're gonna be stars together. They trying to collaborate and not gonna get lucky with somebody that's just a page. Let's keep going. Honey, honey, hope you're having a good fucking day. Description box, community board, for my email, Cash App me, PayPal, and you know why? Because I'll get it quicker than having to go through my emails and look through them, and I have no problem doing it because I do it anyway. So, yeah, this person wasn't being cautious with who they were studying or collaborating with. What's up with this Ten of Swords? What situation in your life needs to come to an end? That's what they gonna see with the communication. Are they gonna see how many times they gonna get repeatedly backstabbed from different people? Are they gonna keep going through the same shit again? And then they gonna see why you put up boundaries, you don't care about having sex, or why you don't wanna participate, and why it was so easy for you to stand on business. And it wasn't about standing on business. This is just what you learned to do with people that didn't respect where you was coming from. They didn't review everything. So while they should have been spying on this person, looking them up, trying to do their background check and follow-ups and shit, they should have been fucking doing it with these people that they've been around or wanted to collaborate with. Yeah, well, let's see about this time moment. See, that's why I kept picking a different card when authority came out. Like, man, that sound boring. Man, I want to, like, spirit, give me something juicy. Oh, I felt something about to be juicy. So let's see about this time moment. Yeah. Yeah. Now they want to change partners or change residents. They want to change business partners. They want to change, So this is another cycle that they going through, that they probably met someone online, and then when they got over there, they changed their mind, or they seen through some kind of backstabbing ass shit, or repeated things over and over. Like, goddamn, the walls are dirty, the toilet's been dirty. The kids are not, nothing's very clean. They don't care to wash the dishes. Like, it was, or maybe they don't even care if they living like that, but they didn't review something of heart and intellect with some kind of communication. So now this person wants to change partners. That's your person. Now let's see what you up to over here healing. And what other aspects of your life do you probably feel like you need to heal or balance? Yeah. These gold diggers keep coming up to you. Trying to just get with you about what you need. Don't worry about that. Remember, you damn if you do, you damn if you don't. And you in reality about the commitments they want with you. They just want to use you and make you play games. Like, I met this guy, he was cool. And he was like, he haven't called me. And I really did want him to call me. And then I forgot about him. And so when he called, when he mentioned where I met him, I didn't remember. That's how I know. And I kept saying for a while. And then when I finally talked to him and I remembered, he said, I can't give you all of me. And I don't know what I told him. Oh, he asked me, what was I doing? Was I in the area? And I told him, I'm off today. He said, oh, okay. he said something whack, you know, and I said, you boring. And like, I can't give you all of me. I'm like this, you know, like, you ain't called me. I forgot who the fuck you was. And at least if you call, have something to do or actually call me. Can I talk to you later? Yeah, I could talk to you later. Then he called. Well, I didn't call because I had went to the gym. Boy, I said, block. So you mean tell me if you can't give me all of you, and who cares what that is? That mean you gonna play fucking games with me? Tell them? Bitch, what you think this is? Do I look like, rolling around sick, Spidey, Spico, a dog, you know? Do you trying to train, groom me? Anyway, honey, like I said, there's gonna be communication issues that these people have no backbone. They have no boundaries. My neighbor, she cool, but she called me at 6:00 in the morning. Then I was like, I'm at work when I don't answer, so she can know I'm not just ignoring her. This bitch was still sending me pictures of her and her twin and pictures while I'm at work. And I know I told her I use my app when I'm at work. I said, I know what it is. She doesn't have boundaries. Yeah, these people, they gonna want to go on a honeymoon with you. They gonna look at you like something with value. But they not gonna want no commitment. And you gonna be in reality that they're not researching you or looking at you the right way. And you gonna put an end to a lot of people. That means you really got it going on. You have to hear from these gold diggers. Are you going to have to probably keep to yourself and remember who you are? And don't let looks and all this sexual attention get you caught the fuck up, especially if you haven't been really sexually active. Hell, if you've been going this long, keep being strong. Congratulations. And let's get on to the next stop, which will be money. Yes, when I do your energy read, I could put all these cards for you. This is the third one, fourth one. 9 different cards. The ones you see on here for $20. Yes, you're going to be into sales. Are your sales going to go up? Are you thinking about something you should sell? Are you buying things on sale? Maybe you should look for a sale. To get some unexpected income. Maybe you're gonna get more tips, bonus points. Yeah, you're gonna have somebody wanna compete with you. You probably know who this person is. When you get this unexpected income, I guess that will be the gold diggers that's trying to compete with you. And then you might have some gold diggers that want to compete with you. That's going to be mean to you. Even, you know, the same sex. So that's probably what you might have to realize when people being mean to you or being nasty or overlooking you or something. They want competition because you're going to be the shit. And I just told you that. Sales, whatever you're doing when it comes to sales, it could even be how you getting money, unemployment. Yeah, toxic work environment. This person, this probably not you, right? If you're not in a toxic work environment. So this could be a person that sell dope and in a toxic work environment. They could steal, they could be sneaky and play favoritism and be getting away with shit or just smoking, doing drugs, but talking and gossiping. Yeah. Unexpected income is going to come in since you lost your job or somebody lost their job and it was toxic anyway. or you got unexpected income coming in, and maybe these people that want to compete with you didn't think you was going to keep thriving because they was toxic. Yeah, overspending. So these people that want competition with you, they're, oh my God. So you got a person that's had a toxic job and a bitch that lost their job or got terminated from a job trying to compete. And our old job you was at, and they overspend. But let's tell them what's their karma, friend. And I hope you share these videos as well. As you do, like and subscribe. Leave me a comment. Let me know what's up. So somebody could be selling drugs, selling ass. She could be on OnlyFans, however, selling bundles. Whatever they're selling, they could be scamming or make up their own products, soap and candles and shit. Who knows? They could sell bootlegs. They can sell things bootleg from their job, stealing. But whatever they're doing, they're going to have to make a huge decision. And I think that your person selling drugs or at a toxic environment or whatever they're doing, where they probably even selling themselves and being toxic, acting like they one way and they really another, so they can make huge decisions. So somebody that's selling probably drugs and they had a toxic job or they doing something they have no business doing, gonna have to make a huge decision. And then you have someone, and let's go back. We talked about how we have two people that they collaborate together and one is just a page. And your person trying to avoid a tragedy. A debt paid came in reverse. So your person is trying not to have a tire moment because somebody they got with was at a toxic job. They lost their job. And then they trying to overspend because both of them are either competing with you or competing with each other or competing, period. With the unexpected income they got, which could have been your person. So while your person was over there helping them, remember they want to build a bed, put someone together. So your person over there buying them clothes, these guys, over there, you know, putting food in their house, cleaning their house, washing their clothes and shit. He over there getting hair and nails and doing stuff for them and wasting money, and now they ain't got shit to show for it. They done lost their job. They in competition. You make a huge decision. You out of debt. Since you lost your job, you've been getting unexpected income. Or when you did lose your job, or you will lose your job, you will get unexpected income, and that could be unemployment. Yeah. And they got deadlines to meet, and so do you. So while you over there making huge decisions out of debt and making your deadlines, probably even drinking your coffee, whatever's keeping you going with that power, and you see how that hourglass is going, but you see how the time is at the top. So this shit just started. So even they buying things they can't afford. Let's see why with these roasted cars as well. What other tragedy they trying to avoid? So that's one of the things why your person seemed quick through the communication why shit had to come in. Because even when they were having deadlines and shit was getting cut off, or this person knew they couldn't afford it, they were spending money anyway because they just the page. Okay. And your person was in a king, and this is the truth. That's what this is. They want you to know the truth. Okay. This is the King of Swords energy from the past, but the King of Swords is the truth about communication, that sword. Spirit wants you to know the truth. So they got with someone quick and seen quick that, damn, this person can't even afford to get their lashes. They can't even afford to buy this beer or go out with their homies, and they doing it anyway. And they don't care, probably because your person was giving them the extra income where they became like a monster. Okay, we're going to roast them. This is good. Yes, honey, let me know what's up in my comment section. Ooh. Love and gaslighting. That's what's going on. That's the truth. Spirit, what else is the truth? Love and gaslighting. Of course. Your person got with someone. Now they trying to avoid a towel. They can't get this bitch to stop spending money. They can't. They love and gaslighting each other. So are your person. They over there competing with you. And it's the truth, because you got more than characters, but you dress nice. This is a motherfucker that don't. So you're not a witch, you know what I'm saying? So your person over there with a witch bitch or some fake ass warlock, and they are, you know, they over there gassing each other up, child. They both ain't shit. So this person could be doing it on purpose if they're energy vampire, and they probably think it's funny trying to take this person's money, acting like you were doing it before, and, you know, like being hateful and mean for because they want to be like you. Yeah, this person, you don't need therapy, and you're not trolling them. That goes along with your character and morals. You're not a witch, bitch. You're not some fucking warlock. Yeah, they second and third guessing over there. So this person, I guess whenever they start thinking about what your person did or whatever, they make them do things. They try to play games with them, make them spend money. That's their punishment. This person look at it like that. Let's see what you over there doing. Yeah, so you might be second and third guessing the LGBT community or the people around you that could be in that community, but you're not reviewing everything, or you don't watch it. You're really not worried about it. Yeah, you're not really worried about it. You're just worried about having a clean environment, a clean ass, and a house clean, or food to eat, shelter. You know, that's the energy you in. Yeah, you see the red flags out here. You see these people loving, gaslighting, they dress nice. And you probably do see the people that's dressed nice and do have morals and characters in the community. But you still second and third guessing a lot of shit about people's self-care, about how they really taking care of themselves. Just people in general. Yeah, you're not a simp. So you second and third guessing, you really paying attention if people are walking it like they talking, or you stand up for yourself at a significant time in these motherfucking streets, because you dress nice, but don't get it twisted. You might be nice, but you're not weak. You might be nice, but you change your, you might agree, but you could change your motherfucking mind. You might take, you're going to take the consequence because you grown as fuck type of energy. Like I said, these people probably have it all together. So that's what's wrong with them. They need self-care. That's what your person seen early. Your person seen the love and gaslighting, the energy vampire shit. They start second and third guessing. This person probably dressed more good, had no morals and characters, and only looked good in the community. Or they had secrets with that moon. Or they acted happy. I think they acted happy with this yellow and orange in the community. But that probably wasn't the case. They acted. Yo, person, like they over there fucking a goat that won't stop bucking and trying to run. Stop. They jumping on shit. Yeah. Let's see about the love then. What's going on with the love? You are so different from the people around me. Makes a lot of sense. So this is the truth. They love is crazy because you're going on. They want to know, is it over? This is the truth. You were right. You're different from some everyone around me. You was right. You told this motherfucker y'all relationship that or what y'all had or who you were. You were different. You so what is that? What they didn't want to believe? You are too nice. I don't deserve your kindness. This love is crazy that they're in. Like I said, cause you're not doing. You're not the one that's causing all this. Why can't I tell you the truth? Is it over? Why can't I tell you the truth that I'm trying to, as soon as I got with this person, I realized real quick that all they cared about was looking good for everybody else. I got with this person, all they cared about was talking on the phone with their friends and telling everybody our business. I got with this person and they didn't even tell me about other friends that they had been knowing that they've been talking to that I didn't, you know, sneak in talking to or thought it wasn't a big deal. I got with a person that's just a page that's not very creative and really don't have it financially. I got with someone and was giving them the difference when it came to the money or giving them things to control them. And now this person lost their job because they got so in this diva, in this gigolo energy where they really thought they was pimping your person to the point where they probably got comfortable. See, before your person came, they probably was dealing with a toxic job. But then they started showing their ass and feeling themselves at this toxic job. And then they probably felt, well, not that your person could support them. They just got into the engine. And I feel like that's a big thing. They lost their job. Maybe your person was picking up the light bill or picking up slack, but they knew your person could not provide all of it because they a page. And your person trying to prevent a tower, trying to prevent tragedy, trying to prevent losses. And they, your person went over there thinking, already going through shit, already been through the cycle. Remember, they're going to keep repeating negative cycles. Your person went over there, and this person probably, like my middle sister, when my middle sister, when she used to get a man, she used to start talking, she a Leo, she started having a fucked up attitude, like, we ain't shit because she got a man engine. She started being more cocky and bold. Even with her kids, she was rude. And it's like, damn, every time this bitch get a man, she start feeling her motherfucking self. Bitch act like she really got it going on. Don't keep a job. I thought my shit stopped recording. But either way, man, scam likely came. But I hope it don't miss. I don't know what my phone just flashed at me as a message. But let me keep it going. So this person probably got cocky with people because your person was validating them through helping them financially, having sex with them, and even just being there and making them feel like they more than what they are. They lost their motherfucking job and now they still want to spend and act like they live that life. They're not in reality. That's why your person is over there thinking of the options they might have. I think that was in the last video if you've been keeping up with me. I can't talk to you right now. You're damn right. You're trying to avoid tragedy. So your person probably, not only are they having to fuck off their money to make this person happy, or to, they your competition, so they both probably fronting like they got it, and they both probably don't want to say they don't. It's like shit about to really get in the tire moment. So just imagine your person trying to fuck off money, trying to prove something to you or to this person that, you know, that they really don't want to be with you, or that they want to be there, plus try to save to move the fuck around, plus trying to make their goals and dreams, or thought that whatever they was going to build with this person, it was going to come out to something. And we know when you dealing with problem people or narcissists, problems never stop. They always have problem after problem, and they create their problems because they purposely create problems to control you. They purposely create problems because they don't like themselves. They purposely create problems because when things are going smooth, they think something's wrong. I don't want to be alone. This karmic might think your person love is crazy with them, and that they are too nice, and that they don't deserve their kindness. This is how this person, this karmic, and this karmic just don't want to be alone. So this karmic need people and clothes and things to validate them. That's what your person seen quick when they went over there, and this is the truth. The way I've treated you is wrong. Yeah. Your person want to know, is it over? Why I can't tell you the truth that I'm over here being a simp. And that's why simp came in reverse for you and standing up for your motherfucking self at a significant time. And why that seven of wands came in reverse, them not getting lucky with not putting their boundaries up. Oh, seven came in reverse, so they not getting lucky. Even though they might be still putting their boundaries up. Maybe they're not putting their boundaries up to the right things, and that's this bitch overspending. Let's keep it going, child. To features before my time run out. I don't have that long. No. Let's go here real quick. The soul. Romantic soul chords. Hope y'all enjoy my readings. Let me know what's up. Welcome back. And for those that like and subscribe, I really appreciate you, excuse me, for supporting my channel. I really do support and hope that one day that we can do an energy reading together, especially if you're going through things. But you got family issues in reverse. You're doing good. Make the effort is what you're doing. Great love is worth taking the steps God is to take. You're keeping an open mind. I feel like you're the one that don't have family issues. Oh. I guess your person healed from their family issues. If you've been keeping up with me, it says this person has healed. But they might have issues when it comes to their kids. Who's keeping an open mind? I'm sorry, I'm a little faster. Somebody that wants to reconcile. Someone from your past wants to return to your life. They came.